This Magic's Music Maker tutorial looks at the basics of how to make music with Magic's Music Maker 2021. So if you're new to home studio music production and you're interested in getting started with Magic's Music Maker free, premium, or plus, then this Magic's Music Maker tutorial is for you. I'm Zane. Welcome to Simple Green Tech. And one thing to note is I'm using Magic's Music Maker 2021 Premium, but everything I'm going to show in this video will be able to be done in Magic's Music Maker Free. And if you still need a copy of Magic's Music Maker Free, I've linked to it down in the description so you can easily click, head over and grab it for yourself. But right now, let's jump into this tutorial and we're going to start off with setting up your audio interface for recording. All right, so I have a new project open here. And what we want to do first is check to make sure our audio interface is set up for recording. So just go up here and click on these gears here, then click on the audio MIDI tab. And if you don't have an audio interface, you could probably leave whatever the default is in there and just use that, because you're probably not really going to be recording. But if you do want to record using your onboard sound card, you should probably download AZO for All and use that as your audio interface in here. So if you have an audio interface, set it to the AZO driver, and then you would just click here and find whatever audio interface it is that you might be using. And you also want to make sure that up here, it has the correct output. So it would be whatever the output is on your audio interface. It probably will show up there by default. But if it doesn't, you can just click and choose whatever you want. And when you have all of this set up correctly, you could just click OK and get out of here. And we're now ready to record some audio into Magic's Music Maker. And by default, it always adds this piano plugin up here. So I usually delete it. You can if you want, you don't have to. But I'm just going to right click, delete that track. And you can always add another track in here by going up to Edit and then Add New Track. So what you want to do is go to the track that you want to record your guitar onto. I'll do track one and click this button right here. And you can see it says audio record, and you should be able to hear your guitar or whatever it is you're recording after you press that. So there's my guitar. And now we're ready to record it. Now that it's armed for recording, whenever we press the record button, it's going to record whatever we start inputting into this track. So let's try that out right now. All right, so that's just a little guitar track there. And another thing I should note is you may want to enable the metronome before you start recording so that you can hear a bit of a click track and keep beat. And you just do that by clicking this on right here. So we have a raw guitar track. There's no effects on it or anything. What you might want to do is add a guitar amp sim, and you can add this before you even start recording. So you can record with this guitar amp sim on, and I'll show you how to do that. You go to effects, and then you want to go to audio effects rack track. And then you go down here to the plus sign, click on that, and you see Magic's plugins here. Find Vandal SE in there. And you might not have all of these plugins. Like I said earlier, I'm using the premium version, so I have a few extra plugins, but the free version will have Vandal SE in there. So click on that. And here's our guitar amp sim. If you click here where it says default, you can choose one of these presets here. So I'm going to choose British Rock, and we'll hear what that sounds like now. You can just close this down. So you want to unarm this track for recording so we can play it back, and you just click here until it's no longer bright red. And now let's play it back. So let's do that again. I'll show you with and without. So this is with it on, and that's with it off. And of course you can change the preset. So if you had this plugin on while you were recording and you thought you liked the tone, but then you decided you want to change it, just click on another preset or dial in your own settings in here and change it up. Let's listen to what this sounds like now. And if you wanted to record with that Vandal SE guitar amp sim on, you would just add the effect before you started recording, and that would work for you. And recording vocals is pretty much the same process. You're just recording vocals instead of a guitar. Then you could add different effects, and you can see there's some presets here for vocals. So you could say you want double vocal track. Just click on that, and now you'll notice when we go into the audio effects rack track, it has some different effects in here with some settings that are ideal for vocals. Before we get into the MIDI section of this Magix Music Maker tutorial, I just want to ask, if you're enjoying it so far, can you please give it a thumbs up? It really helps my channel out, and I appreciate it so much. Now, back into the tutorial. All right, now let's set up our MIDI controller, and this is just quick. So if you don't have a MIDI controller yet, don't worry. This isn't going to take too long, and I'll also show you how to work with MIDI without a controller. So first, you want to go back up to these gears, go to the Audio MIDI tab, and then in the input device, if yours isn't listed here, you want to click on this and then choose whatever controller you have. And you don't have to worry about the output device unless you're outputting MIDI to an external instrument or something like that. But for this, we're just going to worry about the input device. So once you've done that, click OK. And I'm just going to mute our guitar track for now, as we're just going to focus on the next track, which will be a MIDI track. And now we're going to add an instrument onto track two. So click this plus sign here. Like I said earlier, I'm using the premium version, so I'm going to have a few more options in here, but I'm going to use an instrument that actually comes with the free version for this. Let's just click on that. This is Revolta 2. It comes with Magix Music Maker free. And you can see when I added that instrument, it's automatically set it for MIDI recording. If it wasn't, you would just click on this until it said MIDI recording. So I'm going to play something on my MIDI keyboard just to make sure it's working. So if the default sound isn't what you're looking for, you could just click here. Then you can find a preset that gets you in the area of the sound that you want, and then you can adjust it afterwards, or you can just use the preset how it is. So I'm going to check out this one. Let's hear how that sounds. Not too bad. That's what I'm going to go with. So now I'm going to hit the record button and we'll record some MIDI into Magix Music Maker. And this time I'm going to turn on the metronome. So let's hit record. And there's a simple MIDI recording that we did. And if we want to edit this further, we can double click on this. And it opens up our little piano roll here. And in here, you can fix up your playing a bit. So if you were slightly offbeat, which it looks like I was, you could just click on the note that you need to adjust and you can drag it over. Or we can quantize all of our notes. And to do that, we'll just go up here and we're going to select quarter notes. You can choose whatever you want. And then I'm going to click on this Q right here. And you can see it's moved all of these to the start of the quarter note. And now everything is perfectly on time. Another thing to note is that down here, you have your velocity information. And you can see I have all the notes selected, so I'm changing the velocity of everything. But if you wanted to just change the velocity of one, you would click out so you're not selected on everything. And then you just click and drag this to change the velocity of each note. You can also add notes in if you really wanted. You would just go up here and click on this pencil tool. And then you can click wherever you want to add a note in. And you can change the velocity of the notes that you add in as well. If you want to get rid of them, just right click on them and they go away. Now, what if you don't have a MIDI controller, or say you don't want to use your MIDI controller, you just want to insert some MIDI notes using your mouse? Well, go up to Edit, then go to Object, Create New Object, and you want to create new MIDI object. And you can select how many bars it is. For this, I'm just going to go with two bars. And there's our two bar empty MIDI track. Double click on it. There's our empty MIDI. And now we can just draw in our notes. And you can make these notes longer if you want. You would just click on the edge of it and then drag like that. And you can see when I try to move it around or when I'm trying to extend it, it's automatically locked to the quarter note. And you can turn that off by clicking this right here. And now I can freely move this wherever I want. I can also extend it however long I want. So now let's look at arranging audio and MIDI in our timeline here so we can start arranging our song. And another thing is, I'll also bring in some audio over here from one of the sound pools. This is the Music Maker Feel Good sound pool. It comes with Magic's Music Maker Free, so you should have this one. And then you can see over here the different instruments that you want. And it shows you how many different samples are in that instrument. So let's bring in a drum beat. Then down here, you have all the different drum beats that are included. If you click on one, it starts to preview it, and then you can click on it again to stop that preview. If you like it, just click, and we'll drag it into an empty track. You can also click and drag it into a new track if you really wanted. Now, if we were using an instrument like a bass or a guitar or a piano or something like that, you can see up here we have different pitches. So you click on bass, click on the one that you wanted. So let's say that's the one we wanted. If we wanted a different pitch, we could click here and drag that in. And now you can see it says C3, so that's a different pitch. So let's hear how that sounds. So it sounds different than when we clicked on it over here. So that's dragging sounds from the sound pools over into your timeline. Now let's just look at working with our MIDI clips and our audio clips in the timeline. You can see this is a really long clip here. It's longer than our others, so we might want to shorten that. And you can do that by going to the edge of it. You'll see that the cursor has changed to two arrows. You would just click and drag until it's wherever you want it. Say we want it there, and then if we just wanted to duplicate this, you can hold down Control on your computer keyboard, then click and drag, and it's going to create a duplicate of that clip. And you can also do that with MIDI clips as well. And if you want to copy a whole section, say we want to copy all of this section, you would just click and hold down Control while clicking on all of the clips that you want to copy. So say we want to copy everything or duplicate everything, then we just keep holding down Control and drag. And you can see it's copied everything. Now that we have all of these clips in here, we might want to do a little bit of mixing. So you want to go up to View and then go to Mix and click on Mixer. And that brings up our mixer here. So you can start adjusting levels of each thing. You can add effects to each track, adjust the pan, you can solo and mute. Plus you also have a mastering section over here. So this is your master track where you can also add more effects. Let's say your song's mixed, you've got it all arranged, you're now ready to render it to an MP3 so you can share it with the world. So what you want to do for that is go up to File, then go to Export. And if it is MP3 that you want to export as, you would just go to audio as MP3. Select the bitrate. I suggest selecting 192 or higher. And you can click here to browse to wherever it is you want to save it. I would take normalize off, but that's up to you. If you want it normalized, which would give it peak levels, then you can leave that on. And another option here is the only export the range between start and end markers. So if you have, like I do here, I have this yellow start and end marker here. If I only wanted to render what was under that, I would select this. If you don't select that, it's going to render whatever is in the timeline. And then when you're ready, just click OK, and you can see it's mixing down. And then you'll have your MP3 that you can upload to wherever it is you want to upload it to. One thing to note is with the sound pools, if you plan on making any money with your music or even posting it on YouTube and you have a monetized channel, any monetization at all, you must purchase an additional commercial license for that specific sound pool that you want to use. You can post your music on YouTube or wherever it is you want to post it. If you aren't using sound pools, you're just recording your own audio in and maybe using some of the virtual instruments, then you're fine. You can make as much money as you want with using Magic's Music Maker. But if you are using the sound pools, you must purchase that commercial license in order to make money. But if you post it to YouTube and you're not monetized yet, that doesn't matter. You can post it to YouTube and share it all you want, as long as you're not making money using it. And again, that just goes for the use of the sound pools. And it doesn't matter if you have the premium, plus, or free version. You must purchase that commercial license if you want to use the sound pools to make money. If you want to check out my Magic's Music Maker tutorial playlist, click up here. Or click down here to see what YouTube recommends. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching for Simple Green Tech. I'm Zane, keep creating, and we'll talk soon.